The lines lit up. I need to take the call. Welcome back to 189.16, The Scream. This is Forrest Nash. How are you tonight, caller?
I'm doing okay. I made it home safe.
Gary!
Hey, I just wanted to thank you for doing what you could earlier. You know, even though not everybody made it, and I don't know.
Hey, it's okay. You were so brave earlier. You're safe now.
I wanted to ask you why. Why he didn't... Why am I...
Why what, Carrie?
Why did he spare me? After what he did, why let me go?
Maybe he only wanted to hurt the pranksters.
Maybe. Did he just think everyone was making fun of him? Did he always hate these hazing rituals? I mean, if he did, why wait all these years to... Why do this now?
These stupid hazing nights have to stop. Carrie, you did so well tonight. Stay safe and rest. Help is coming to Gallows Creek. We just need to hold on.
Thanks, Peggy. Hey, Forrest, could I request a song?
Of course, Carrie. What song?
Any song by Blast Processor. And thank you.
This next one goes out to Carrie.
You know, what Carrie just said has really got me thinking.
About what?
The whistling man left her alone. Why? There must be a reason.
When it comes to masked whistling killers, I don't think a reason is a key part of their process.
Well, it's something to consider. I need to take a break. If you want to stretch your legs, now's the time. Just hit the Peggy button when you want to get back on air.
Not getting in there tonight.
Thank you.
Nice. New music to play. I need a key to get in there. That's not opening. Let's get going, Peggy.
Alrighty, we could run another segment or... Scratch that for us. We have a caller.
You're through to 189.16, The Scream. What's your emergency?
Hello again, Forrest. Oh, that call with the teens was awful. Those poor kids. Still, I'm glad the girl didn't get hurt.
Thanks for your concern. Are you in trouble? What's on your mind?
I wanted to ask you again to play my song, Forrest. You said you were gonna play it, but you didn't.
Your name was Dawn, right?
What, Peggy? Yes. Oh, well remembered. My name is Dawn, and I wanted to ask you again to play my tune, Forrest. Long Ride Home? You know, the one that Peggy said she threw outside the window?
We don't have that song. As you just said, Peggy threw it out the window.
But, Forrest, you do have it. It's just outside the window.
There's a serial killer on the loose. I can't just go outside hunting for a record.
I'm really sorry, Dawn, but we just can't get it right now.
But wasn't the whistling man just at the old murder house? That's miles from the station. It won't take you a second to grab it.
Don, I'm not sure if you've heard, but there's something unnatural about this freak. He's fast. I'm not risking it.
Oh, but I think you will. Forrest? Peggy, I'm calling with more than a request. I know something. I think I know who's gonna be next.
What?
Are you serious?
Play my song, Forrest, and you'll find out.
Well, folks, here's some music for you while I think things over. Is she serious, Peggy?
She's serious about hearing that song, that's for sure.
Peggy, I mean, is she serious about...
I don't know, Forrest, but we don't really have a choice, do we? If she's telling the truth...
Doves here, and they are pretty mean.
I don't care. I don't want to go out there.
Forrest, someone might be in danger. And despite your being so damn curmudgeonly, I think you...
Stop it, Peggy. Just... I'll go.
You're a good man, Forrest. I'll slide you the key to the fire door.
Fuck you,
wait,
Peggy.
Wait. Our fire door has to be unlocked?
Yeah, it... you know, I never thought about it, but yeah. We should talk to Reggie about that later. Anyway, I'll hold the fort down while you're out. Maybe I'll even get a caller. That could be exciting.
189.16.
With me, Peggy.
Fuck you, Peggy. It's not the fire door, it is.
Locked tight.
This isn't the fire door either, but hey, I wanted to check.
You know, I hope she'll be happy when I'm brutally murdered by the Whistling Man. Out here. In the open. Alone.
Which is going to happen, of course. What is this? Battery. Where, on which side did she throw it out of the window? We need to know. Another battery.
Of course, it locks behind me. And of course the key doesn't work on this side. Fantastic. Alright, which window would she have thrown it out of? Maybe there's another way back in through the basement. A door, elevator, or something. And that's broken too. Only the best for KFAM.
See if I can fix this. Looks like a power issue. I should check the fuse box.
Where the fuck is the fuse box? Oh, here's the music. Oh, I need to
Looks
find
like
one more.
I'm gonna have to hunt around for some new fuses.
Hmm. Come on, pick it up. It's right there. Thank you.
Nah, that's not right. Do the fuses add up properly?
What do you mean, add up? It's at 70. Are there more fuses then?
Looks like I'm gonna have to hunt around for some new fuses.
Let's have a look if we see more. Fucking darkness. Not liking it. It's too dark. My eyes get hurt. Here we have a 5, so we have... Ten? Wait, I'm going stupid now. That's fine. This is 60.
Bingo!
Here it is. Long ride home. I could probably survive that fall.
Good, can we now close it? I don't think leaving that
looks
open.
Like the janitor's closet. What did Peggy say his name was? Clive?
What? What?
What the hell? Peggy is not gonna believe this.
Yeah, I don't want to take anything from here because... Maybe.
Look, there's a key. I'll just take that. Might be important.
Always misplace a key, right? But this looks kinda... And if he... So if he's our janitor... Then he can probably just get in whenever he wants, right? Feel like it's gonna be a jump scare soon because it's been so dark.
I wonder how the show's going.
I'm lost. I know where I am, but oh no, this is reception, right? Yeah. Okay.
Isn't that such a good song, folks? And now for... Jesus, Forrest, you've been gone for ages. I thought something had happened.
Something did happen. Clive the janitor might be Clive the murderer.
Hey, what? Quest, I'm sorry. I was very concentrated in walking around here, and it's so dark. How are you? How was your weekend so
Why
far?
Why did you heave that thing all the way up here?
Because the basement's creepy as hell, and I don't like standing around down there.
Fair. Alright, let's run through this again. We have a creepy board you found in a creepy basement, made by our creepy janitor.
I didn't
who you think
take the
is
board.
The creepy whistling man.
Yep.
And on the creepy board are the names Chuck Brody, Kim Walker, Rebecca Allen, and Aunt Williams.
Correct.
And you think one of these people will be the Whistling Man's, Clive's, next target?
That's right. And we've got to find them.
You said there are four locations listed there, too? The hospital, the power station, the gas station, and the trailer park. Clive must think the target is at one of those locations. Forrest, you're going to have to figure out if any of the potential targets are at one of these locations tonight. Hit the button if you need any help.
Was it the hospital? The gas station, so that's there. No, that's the train station, that one. It was still fun, that's good. Yeah, it's getting warmer, right? So allergies will... get annoying. It's that time of the year. Okay, so that's the hospital, gas station, trailer park, power station. This power station? I just had a in, and then I didn't. Or I can just do... Oh, I can't get... So, what do you have to do in this game? I'm, radio station host, and let's just do this. In a small town, I guess, and the sheriff got killed. No, but I got bored. Sis. Hi. Yeah, so the sheriff got killed, and the one deputy or whatever is taking another hurt police officer out of town and we'll get hopefully the cavalry to come save us, because a murderer who was killed ages ago suddenly came back to life, or so it seems, and 911 has been redirected to the radio station. So where is it? Jason? No, it's the Whistling Man. But yeah, so we get calls from listeners, but also from people who need 911. And we try to save them, only I haven't been that successful. So now I don't really know what I'm trying to figure out. I'm trying to figure out something. I think maybe, no, maybe not. Hospital. I already had the hospital and the thing, so the trailer park. What is behind this? Adjust studio. Okay. Oh, here's the trader park. What pin did I take? This one. Give me pin, please. Take it. Trade park. On the gas station. Is there anything behind here? No gas stations. Radio station, train station, I don't see the gas station, am I blind? Is it Christine's gas and repair? It could be. Right. Informant as R.A. Wait, didn't we have a Rebecca Allen? Can I put it on the... No, okay, that's Rebecca Allen. Probably. What? What was... What was in game? Oh no, that's outside. Yeah, no, that's outside. 30th of May 1970. Kim Walker and Peter Stein. Might not. I'll put that here. But wait. Oh, here. Kim. Sounded like it was triggered by the article. Okay, well, it wasn't. It was just, that been very loud lately. I don't know what to do with this. So we'll just do nothing. Two engineers are entering the power station. Okay, so we have the power station, where did it go? This. With this one. I don't have anything for Chuck yet. No, I want it lower. Come on. Okay, can I put this here now? Alright, this also has to do with Kim. But somehow I can put it lower. Who's that then? Oh, that's Rebecca Ellen. Christine's got some repair. I've been sold to a man who won't bother me. Local legend takes diary of a car thief. Well, that's this. So this is Rebecca. Is your car safe? Share with Matthews. Okay. Okay, so just do it with mouse. It's better that way. This one here for Kim. So that's the power station. This is also power station. Local legend takes, and that was Rebecca. Chuck. Oh, here we have Chuck. Buying him some lottery tickets. So this is Chuck. And this is probably Chuck. And then this... been a man who won the lottery 14 years ago. So that's Chuck as well. Featuring special mystery guest, a lead engineer responsible for Gallo. Oh, I'm sorry. So that's the one down here. That's and we're in 87 now, right? I only stole a few cars, so that's that one. Fail to stop and crash the fuel tanker. Please have been identified as Mr. Giro, Mr. M. Mr. P. Stein, Mrs. K. Stein, J. Mildred. I'm sorry. We had a wedding announcement here. So if I look at it this way, then this is gonna be gas station. Trailer park. Hospital. And power station. Maybe. Right?
How's it going?
I'm ready, Peggy.
Are you sure? We've only got one shot at this.
Actually, give me a bit longer.
But then I could use some
help. How's it going?
It's not going well. I could use some help.
Okay, let's review the basics. We need to work out who the next target is. There's four locations, right? And four people. We need to figure out if anyone is at any of the four locations tonight. And if they are, we can call them and warn them.
It's the third.
There must be some connections between the notes.
That makes sense.
Great. Need any more help?
Is it September? Yes. Okay, so we think it's end.
I'm good now. Thanks, Peggy.
No problem.
And otherwise he dies, it's fine, right?
I'm ready, Peggy.
Are you sure? We've only got one shot at this.
I'm sure. Let's do this.
Okay, name first. Who do you think the target is?
Aunt Williams.
And where will I find them?
The power station.
Okay, I'm dialing. One moment. Forrest, I'm through to the power plant, but...
87.
They say there isn't anyone by that name there.
What? Then who?
Ah! Jesus!
It sounds like something blew up!
He's using bombs now?
Oh my god. The call board. One moment. Forrest, I'm getting so many calls. Just let me... I'm gonna take us off air for a moment.
Peggy, what's happening in there? Peggy.
Let's turn this off.
I'm back. He blew up the gas station, Forrest.
Okay.
I spoke to the fire department and the hospital. The fire department is useless now, as you know. And, the hospital's only ambulance was at the gas station. Forrest, you've got to say something on the radio. You have to tell the town. I'm putting us back on air. Now.
Gallows Creek. I don't know how to tell you this, but, the gas station's been bombed.
Please, everyone, stay safe, stay inside, and... Oh, just bring us into some music, Forrest.
Yeah, what was the song?
Here's some music while we regroup here on KFAM 189.16, The Stream.
But there was no way It was this.
There's gotta be more in the basement to show us who Clive is targeting. And if that's the case, we can get ahead of him. Stop the killings before they can happen. Forrest, we need to go back down.
I don't want to.
You mean me, right?
I don't want to.
Like I said, I need to handle all these calls. Maybe start with that creepy mannequin room you mentioned before. I still have a lot of questions about those, by the way.
Go down.
Me too.
Just go down and look yourself, Peggy. 18. No, but by all means, let me go down and get killed. It's fine. Who needs a life anyway? Hello, scary ass people.
A key. Was this always here?
What key?
I must have missed it when I brought everything upstairs.
Oh, that key. I didn't even bring stuff upstairs. You know. I did not. Basement storage. So that's the door that was locked, I guess. It was.
Hey, Forrest!
Peggy, give me some warning before yelling down the intercom.
Sorry. Buzz the intercom when you find something and want to discuss it.
Mouse strips. I like how all the doors close automatically.
Peggy, I've found a tape and a map down here.
A map of what?
Looks like it might be to somewhere in this storage area.
Weird. Well, maybe the tape will give us more information. Give it a play.
Yeah, so I don't know if you heard that, but that's just motorcycles and cars outside being too loud.
George Bellows, 1968. That's when this all began for me. Follow the maps, find the tapes.
Wait, George Barrow? We all heard that he drowned after a night out drinking. Was it actually Clive? Has Clive really been the whistling man for that long?
He says I need to follow the maps and find the tapes. I guess that's what this map is about.
I think we need to see what else is hidden down here. Be careful, Forrest. Keep looking. Buzz the intercom when you found something.
Hmm. Flickering lights. Those are always cool. Good stuff. I think we should just keep this. Avery's Hospital.
Time of autopsy is 7 a.m. Cause of death is asphyxiation from drowning. The degree of rigor mortis indicates that the subject has been deceased for 5 hours. That puts the time of death...
I feel like I need to take this with me, but I'm just going to write down the codes. Because I don't know if there's anything else I need to pick up. So main... And... Oh, code... 3... It's 3-1-1-2-1-2, right? My eyes aren't... I don't see everything. Alarm. Off. Alarm. Test. Is it alles uit? We'll turn off all security measures. 1-9-1-5-1-9. Test. Deactivation. 8-1-1-2-2-0. And entry 715914. If you make a mistake while entering the security code, press asterisk. Okay. Okay, so I can... drop this. This might be interesting. Where was I going? Here, I guess. Because this is going to get me killed. Flickering lights.
Additionally, there appears to be a post-mortem injury to the arm. It looks like it was trapped in a car door.
Car door?
Okay.
this. Should I go back and tell her what I found, or do I just get myself killed here?
What the?
I'm a man who likes to stay informed. I've got subscriptions to newspapers all over the country. A few weeks ago, I noticed headlines cropping up in those papers, one after the other. Each headline about a murder. Each murder, the death of someone I knew almost 20 years ago. And each one, drawing closer to Gallows Creek. Drawing closer to the anniversary. None of us are innocent. But I don't think we deserve killing. All I hope now is that I can save some folk from the worst. That I can. I don't know. Do something to make up for what I did back then, I guess. I didn't kill anyone, mind you. But that's past mattering. Now, there's more I could say than I should say. But my employer made it clear that my family would pay a high price if I
My employer?
So,
okay, I'm going to turn my camera for a bit. Still be playing. What's the truth, though?
What the hell? Peggy is not gonna believe this.
I don't believe it. What is happening? Oh, well, that's me. My back really hurts. My whole body hurts. Wait, is this an interesting... No. If you hear this, I'm probably dead. Oh, here's a thing as well. Can I click it? Can I take it?
It is the coroner's opinion that the subject likely feared for his life and was chased, resulting in a fall from a height into a body of water where he hit his head, was knocked out, and drowned. Following that, he was moved.
Dr. Solo, we need to have a talk. Is that recording? Shut it off.
So I can't click this intercom, that's kind of stupid. And so many... I think I've been everywhere, right? Maybe still take that. I wrote it all down, but if I want, there's nothing else.
What have you found, Forrest?
It's an autopsy tape. Doesn't say for who, but I think it must be for George.
Poor George. Young.
Something's bugging me, Peggy.
What do you mean?
I swear I recognize the voice of the woman talking on the tape. I just can't place it.
Seriously? Do you think you've met her before?
I don't know. I mean, I just got here recently. I don't know. I found a tape that introduces a new detail to the story. Post-mortem injury. Apparently, his arm got caught in a car door.
A car door?
Yeah, after he died. How do you suppose they can tell?
How can they tell? I'm a radio producer, not a coroner.
The coroner came to the conclusion that George was running from something, likely terrified.
Maybe an animal?
Maybe, but then there's this next bit, where the coroner thinks he was moved post-death.
Moved the body? How weird.
At the end of the tape, someone burst in and demanded the doctor, Dr. Sullivan, to stop recording.
Dr. Sullivan? Wait, Virginia Sullivan? She was her caller from earlier.
Well, then our caller was involved in a conspiracy around this boy's death. We need to call her back once we finish down here. It looks like she might know something about what's going on. I think I found Clive's last recording. I think Clive might be gone.
Gone?
I found a confession. Not for any killings, but for playing a part in covering up George's death. He left this behind in case he died. He hoped someone would find it. Possibly. We've had a lot of callers tonight, but maybe not every victim made it to the phone, you know? We don't know how many there really are.
Christ, Forrest, that's dark.
I know, but Clive said he had read about other murders in other towns, and that the murders were all folks who knew about the incident, and the killings were getting closer to Gallows Creek. He said he wanted to do something good for once.
The board in his office. He wasn't tracking people down to kill them. He was tracking them down to save them. Ugh, why didn't he just come out with all of this?
He said his employer threatened his family if he spoke out about any of it.
His employer? The one who orchestrated the cover-up? Oh, Clive. I'm sorry for thinking you'd killed all those people. Do you think you found everything, Forrest?
I think there's got to be more down here. I need to find all the tapes.
You think so? How much did Clive hide down there? Well, if there are more tapes, then there must be more maps to follow, right?
That seems to be the case.
All right, then. Buzz the intercom when you find something and want to discuss it.
Pretty. So I'm going back in. Because he thinks I didn't. We've listened to this one, right?
Autopsy is 7 a.m. Cause of death is asphyxiation from drowning. The rigor mortis indicates that the subject has been deceased for 5 hours. That puts the time of death.
I hate flickering lights. I can't stand them.
Preliminary toxicology results shows no signs of inebriation. However, a high amount of cortisol was found, indicating elevated levels of stress in the immediate moments before death. Small lacerations to arms, legs, and face, typically obtained by running through foliage. Severe blistering to the feet, as though the deceased had been running without stopping. Additionally, there appears to be a post-mortem injury to the arm. It looks like it was trapped in a car door.
Didn't we hear that? But I only missed one? Two, I guess. Here we're at the end. There was one in here.
It is the coroner's opinion that the subject likely feared for his life and was chased, resulting in a fall from a height into a body of water.
Hey, Silver. How are you doing? And then his confession.
If you're listening to this, then I'm probably...
I'm fine. I just turned my cam off because I'm lying down a bit. The tattoo is, wait.
A few weeks ago, I noticed headlines cropping up in those papers.
What's that?
One after the other. Each headline about a murder. Each murder. The death.
And then I have to turn my cam on.
And each one,
I have to.
Drawing closer to
But it's white red.
Well, that I can save some folk from the worst. And I can.
But it is.
I don't know.
From a distance you just
do
see the
make up for what I did back then, I guess. I didn't kill anyone, mind you. But that's bad.
When I'm here you just see a huge black spot, but when you come closer, you see the crow.
My family would pay a high price if I ever spoke out. So, hopefully I've said enough.
I'm sorry for the screen. Okay, so let's go back and talk to Peggy again, because I think I heard all the tapes now. No, I'll sit up for a bit. Let's go lie down again.
What have you found, Forrest?
Found another tape. It talks more about how George died.
What did it say?
It sounds like he was running for his life. Sprinting through trees and bushes, getting cut up all over.
What would drive someone to do that?
I'm not sure yet. There's also a tape about a toxicology report. There were no signs of drinking or that he was on anything.
What? But everyone said he went swimming drunk and drowned. It was in the newspaper and everything.
Yeah, so that isn't...
Do you think you
right.
found everything?
I think so.
Forrest, what's going on here?
Someone wanted that boy's death to seem like an accident. And they hired Clive to make it look that way.
Come back upstairs when you're ready. We need to figure out our next step.
God, it's 3 a.m.
Thank God you're back, Forrest. I've been running out of stuff to pad our airtime with.
Peggy, you work in radio.
Forrest, I'm stressed. I mean, really. How are we supposed to keep a show going with all this happening?
You've locked yourself in the fucking... I'm risking my life the whole time. I mean...
This is our job, Peggy. We gotta do it.
You're right.
My
grandmother's what's the plan
today?
Now?
Finally going down a bit.
We should call
That's
Virginia
good.
Back.
Alright, I'll get her on
Hydrate.
The line. When you're ready, shut the music off.
Am I ready?
Okay, Forrest, shut the music off.
Yeah.
Hello again, Gallows Creek. Hello. This is Forrest Nash. We're circling closer to the truth behind tonight's events. To this end, we're calling back one of our earlier callers, Virginia Sullivan.
Fredman Plunker here? Who's this? Is it you? Goose?
Plunker, hey, it's the Radio Man, Forrest Nash.
Radio Man? What's up?
Solving mysteries, saving lives. The huge.
No, it's right on. Not
Plunker,
exactly like Five Nights at Freddy's
house.
Exactly,
she,
not.
She asked if we could stay.
It's pretty. I like it. It's pretty cool.
So
I got people
out,
killed
bro.
Though.
Well, that's big of you, Plunker.
No, it's nothing.
Can I speak to Virginia?
Sure thing, Radio Man. I'll just go get her.
Who is this?
Hey, Virginia, it's Forrest. I'm glad you're still okay.
Oh, Forrest. Sorry, I'm still jumpy.
Don't be sorry. You've been through a lot.
I'm so sorry this happened to you, Virginia.
I thought I was. I thought...
Easy. We're not calling to talk about earlier. We're calling because we think you can help us understand why this is happening tonight.
Me? What would I know?
Does the name Clive mean anything to you?
Clive? No. I don't know that name. What are you asking about this for?
You mentioned that name earlier when you called us the first time.
I don't know what I said then. I was petrified for us.
Yeah, and it's
Clive's
by Studio 17, so that's...
And we know you spoke to him in the past.
Forrest, please.
Or Theme 17. So that's Worms and...
Virginia, it's okay.
Go with your friends
Clive
and
won't be coming
stuff,
after
right?
you.
We think Clive's dead.
Dead? But isn't he? He's the Whistling Man, Forrest.
But he's not.
We thought so too, but...
You don't understand. All those years ago, he...
It's okay, Virginia. He's gone. We found evidence to suggest he... Well...
And we found your autopsy reports for George Barrow.
How? I saw him destroy them.
Well, he didn't. I don't know if he kept them or made copies or what, but we found them. And we know it's related to what's happening tonight, which is why we called you. Why did you stay quiet?
All right. One day, I came into work to find a boy on my slab. And as I finished the autopsy, this man, Clive, he just burst in. And he started making demands to give over the reports, to falsify what I found. Of course I said no.
Of course I said no.
Well, when someone wants to make you do something, they can use the carrot or the stick. For me, he used both.
Hey, Saucy! Hi, how are
you
doing?
My sister is sick.
I'm sorry,
she
I was looking
at
my phone.
She has a chronic condition that's never going away. It's expensive to treat, and it was getting to where I couldn't afford it. And Clive promised me that his employer would pay for my sister's treatment.
Great, that's good.
If I did what he said.
How
and
are
that
you?
If I ever spoke
didn't
about this,
get any sleep.
He'd beat me
I'm
to within
fine.
An inch of my life. I don't know why he had me do it, but my sister needed me. You have to understand. She needed me.
We understand.
I don't. You helped cover up the death of a child.
Forrest!
But he threatened me. And my sister...
You abused your power to help your death.
Oh, God.
Forrest, that wasn't necessary.
Joanna? Welcome! Welcome, raiders! Welcome, Joanna! Hey! Thank you so much for the raid! Vero! It scared you a bit? It's quite loud, right? It needs to wake me up when it happens. You were playing PC Building Simulator. How was it? Did you build a lot of PCs? I played the game ages ago. And then I didn't really like the buying of the parts because I don't like the, I guess it is catalog or something. It doesn't make sense. It was fun and chill. Well, that's what you need on a Saturday, right? We are trying to, I don't know if we're trying to catch a killer or trying to stay alive. While also manning 911 on the radio station. It is a kind of 80s slasher movie thing. Only you don't really see any slashing. You hear slashing if you get people killed, but people call the radio station because they call 911. And you have to try and help them just by searching for information in magazines or, if...
It needed to be said.
You see, I have a lot of stuff here. I have a...
So, Virginia is tied up in all of this.
Clive threatened her to keep quiet.
It's quite a good game, actually. I was interested in it because you just see it as, I don't know. Yes, you're in the radio station. I went out to get a record, but I haven't been in other places.
About George's death, but for who? Why cover up these details?
I played a game called Unheard.
You could try Sandra.
What would Sandra?
I played that as well. Yes, it's a very good game. I hope they make a second one. That they have DLC, but that's all in Chinese, I think, and not in English. So either I need to learn that language so I can play the DLC. Yes, kinda. But yeah. Well, it's only you actually see things, and you have to go find. It's not just listening and making your deductions based on what you heard. But. Yeah, it's a good game. I will just play a bit further.
I don't know if
you like figuring stuff out and
anyway,
being a
just
DJ,
be careful when you're talking to her.
Pushing buttons.
Don't push too hard. We don't want her to hang up.
I'll be careful.
Check it out.
All right, calling her now. Hopefully she's at her jazz studio. Aha. Forrest, you're through.
Hello, this is Sandra at Jazz Pizzazz Jazz Studio. Who is this?
Hello again, Sandra. It's Forrest Nash of 189.16, The Scream. And you're live on air.
Oh, I always thought folks called into a radio show, not the other way around. How jazzy. What can I do for you?
We're trying to understand what's behind the attacks tonight. We had a few questions.
Why, Forrest, of course. Heck, after the way you saved my life, I'd say yes to just about anything you asked.
you know why the Whistling Man might have targeted you?
Ha! As far as I could tell, he was just a knife-wielding psycho with superhuman cardio. He'd have chased after anybody.
Right. Well, we think he might be chasing specific people. People who know about the death of a boy named George.
I don't know anything about that. Sorry.
Have you had to keep quiet about anything? Any secrets you've had to keep?
What would I have to keep quiet about?
I don't know. I mean, could be that you've seen something or heard something.
I never saw anything. And even if I did, what would that matter? And it was years ago.
Drop the axe, Sandra. You know something. What are you hiding?
I don't know anything. Time. Sure is late. I have to go. I'll drive home now, or just drive. I'm sorry.
Well?
I might have gone a bit hard on her.
A bit?
All right. Let's just move on. Well, folks, if anyone out there has any thoughts on what's going on tonight, please call in.
That's good timing. We've got a call waiting just this second.
Oh, nice. Let's go.
Welcome to 189.16 The Scream with me, your host, Forrest Nash.
Hi, Forrest. I know this is really out of the blue with everything happening tonight.
Wait.
But I wondered if you could send this special birthday message to my uncle.
You know what? I'd welcome a change of pace. I'd be glad to.
Thank you, Forrest. He's my Uncle Ronnie. His first name's Peter, but he never liked his name. But since he always had salt and pepper hair, even as a kid, can you believe it? Folks always called him Pepper.
Thanks for the history lesson. Is there anything besides
having my throwing so?
You'd like to say to Mr. Pepper? Oh my God, damn it!
Yes! Tell him he can get the best birthday deals and party packages here at Porny's Pizza, starting at
You son of a bitch! Stop calling us!
Sorry, Forrest. Let's just move on. We've already got another caller on the line.
Another one.
This is 189.16, The Scream. I'm Forrest Nash. You're on the air, caller. Caller. Ponty?
Ponty's Pizza always delivers! Come rain or sleet or whistling man, we'll be there!
Ponty should...
Forrest?
Joke in his pizza.
Forrest? Are you okay?
I'm so fine.
Forrest?
I hope... The Whistling Man gets him with his own pizza slicer.
Jesus, Forrest.
Sorry. That was too much.
It's okay. It's been a high-stress night. Don't worry about him anymore, okay? Not for tonight, anyway. I think he's spent for now. We've got another call, whenever you're ready.
Oh, really? I just want to play some music.
Folks, don't spend your money at Pawnee's Pizza. That's... all I'm going to say about that. Moving along, I'd like to welcome another caller to 189.16 The Scream with me, Forrest Nash. Who may I say is calling?
Well, hello again, Forrest.
Don. I bet I know why you're calling. I'm sorry I didn't play your song. There's a lot going on. But please?
Never mind that now. Forrest, I'm calling because I need your help.
What?
Are you in danger?
Oh, I sure am.
Do you mean...
Yes, he's after me now.
You?
I think so. He must have heard me on the radio, helping you.
Helping? You didn't exactly help.
Maybe I've been helping more than you know. I was out following a lead, trying to work out who would be next, after Chuck.
And what happened?
And I started to feel like I was being followed. I came back to my apartment building, but this newfangled security system has me locked out.
Oh, there we go.
I need you to help me get inside.
Don't you have a key to get in?
Only for the apartment door. The front gate requires an entry code. The future is electronic, I guess. I need that code to get inside.
Which apartment block do you live in? Maybe one of our listeners lives there too.
It's the New Woodside apartment building between the town hall and the trailer park, but I doubt any of your listeners live there. I don't have many neighbors.
Sounds like a prime piece of real estate.
Sound really carries at night. Shit.
Wait. Yeah, no, she's near the skate. She's near Ricky's because you see, here's the train station. But what the trailer park she was talking about was here. So that's nowhere near the train station. She's at Ricky's now. She's the killer. She has to be.
Is that a neighbor's dog?
Yes, it is. Boy, I wish he'd muzzle that thing and... Oh. And now he's blasting David Scopo out of his window. I can't get any...
What's your neighbor's name?
I don't know my neighbors, remember? Please, I need to get in.
What's the name of the security system?
There's a sticker on the box. It says Starling Security 4000. There's a keypad, and it looks like it wants a six-digit number.
Oh, I didn't take the thing with me, did I?
Starling Security 4000, huh?
That's right. Very newly installed. I need the key code before the whistling man gets me.
Yeah, of course. Don't worry, Don.
Thank you, Forrest. I knew I could count on you. I'll sit out of sight. Call me back soon.
Alright, folks. Here's a little tune for you all to enjoy while I try to break Dawn into her apartment.
But I'm not gonna.
You were pretty quiet there, Peggy.
Forrest, was it just me, or was there something...
Wrong, yeah, yes.
It wasn't just you. Something was weird about that.
Yeah. Well, tell you what. We have a Starling 4000, or whatever, here at KFAM. Clive bought one for the station. Maybe we can find something to help. Well, I'm not sure who. But to help someone...
Yeah, but I don't want to.
Okay, so she's locked out of the Woodside Apartments, and somewhere, Clive probably has the papers for the Starling 4000.
Where are the Woodside Apartments? Because she said she was in the trailer park. Oh, here. But that's never... Because she's near Ricky. The train station. This is bullshit. I'm not gonna help her. Oh. Did I take the book with me? I thought I did. I didn't. Because... Wait, I'm going to get it. Oh wow, the game has really low frame right now. Why is that? Is it because we're nearing the end? Or did I throw it here? Yes. Here it is. Come on, pick it up. Pick it up.
Starling 4000. User manual. Ah, these codes should come in handy.
Yeah, but we're gonna get her. And if she isn't the killer, or someone bad, but I think she's not okay. Then she's gonna get killed. Well, she isn't the first one. She made me go outside to get the freaking song she now doesn't want me to play for her. When entering a code commands, make sure to observe. If you make a mistake, okay, I'm going to give her the 9-1 code because I don't like her. She lied to me where she was. Don't lie to me, folks. Let that be a lesson. You might get killed.
Welcome back, Forrest. Find anything?
The Starling 4000 security manual. It's got a bunch of codes.
Good. And did you find anything else?
Nothing, except the manual.
All right. Well, I'll get Dom back on the line then, Forrest. I'll let you take it from here.
Thanks, Peggy.
When you're ready, shut the music off. Line one, whenever you're ready.
Don, are you there? This is Forrest Nash from 189.16, The Scream.
Oh, thank God you're back. I'm so afraid. What's the code to the gate?
The code is 191519.
Thank you, Forrest.
Yeah, well, fuck her.
Yeah, stay out! Nobody disrespects the sixth.
You see, I knew she was there.
I'm calling the cops!
Thank God.
Hello? Is someone there?
Ricky, get back inside and turn on the radio. Whoever that was, she was trying to break into the ring.
She? Forrest, man, you got no idea. That was him!
Him?
That was the whistling man. Alarm gave me just enough time to get my rifle. I don't like hurting folk, but I can't let anything happen to Maxie. He's my best friend, you know?
So that was him?
Listen, man, I'm heading back inside. Gonna barricade that window. My man, thank you. You and Peggy can skate for free whenever you want, forever. That's a done deal.
Yeah.
Thanks, Ricky. Can't wait.
You got it. Talk to you soon.
Okay.
It was just Gallows because Creek. Of the dog.
Here's some music while we process what just happened.
Oh, music. Yes. This one.
So, the whistling man is a woman?
It could have been a whole different story if you gave the right code. I know, right? Yeah, I worked it out a while ago. I have my suspicions.
I had my suspicions.
Yeah, sure, Forrest. You just never mentioned it. She called up. You spoke to her multiple times.
I know, but the last time she lied.
I thought she was just regular Gallows Creek Strange.
Really, Forrest? Why do you think she requested that song?
To get me outside?
Maybe, but how? She didn't know the song was outside to start with.
Unless.
She never actually attacked me out there.
So? What now?
I guess I should make an announcement. We do have new info.
Okay, kill the music and you can make the announcement.
But I opened the elevator hatch, which leaves the cellar.
Turn the music off.
Right open. So
okay,
she can get in,
get in.
Hey folks, this is Forrest Nash here. Hope you're all safely locked inside. For those of you listening to that last call, you might be wondering what to make of it all. Here's our take. We now believe the killer is actually a woman. One who might manipulate you into letting her in before she attacks you. We're neighbors. Look out for each other and stay safe. The killer was calling themselves Dawn.
Killstaking. This could be a fake name.
This could be a fake name. If anyone needs help or you have info on the killer, please call in. You folks have my new number, right? It's 911. Hopefully, our next caller can help shed some light on our killer.
Hey, we had a call come in.
Okay, folks, time to take a call.
It's Dawn.
This is Forrest Nash, and you're listening.
Please help me. My name is Casey Moore. I'm at 25 Nancy Drive. My best friend's been stabbed. He's bleeding everywhere. I don't know what to do. Please help me.
Somebody's been stabbed? Can you tell me what happened?
We've been out at the reservoir. We were heading back to his place when we heard this whistling all of a sudden. He just started freaking out. He screamed at me, told me to hide. I'd never seen him like that, and I just panicked and ran and hid in a bush.
Oh no, Forrest.
Then what happened?
Where's the reservoir? Oh, yeah, I should probably.
Casey, was he talking to a woman?
I don't know. They had a mask and wore all black. That's all I know. Please, we need help here.
I'll get you help, but I need to know. Where did the masked person go?
They left him to bleed out.
No, the 911 is put through to us because
911.
We are 911.
I don't know. I think I heard them say something like, "It's not so funny now, is it?" Before they left, but please, he needs to get to the hospital.
Yeah, but we don't have ambulances.
We need an ambulance!
Forrest, the ambulance was destroyed in the explosion at the gas station. You should get all the info you can.
Can you tell us where your friend was stabbed?
They stabbed him in the stomach, and then stabbed him again in his leg when he was on the ground, and it's... Oh, the knife is still there in his leg!
What's your friend's name, Casey?
It's Jason. Jason Parker.
We'll be right back. Peggy, patch us through to the hospital.
On it. Phoning St. Gabriel's now. Switch to line 2.
Hello, St. Gabriel's Hospital. How can I help you?
Hi, this is Forrest Nash from 189.16. We have a stab victim at 25 Nancy Drive named Jason Parker. He's been stabbed in the stomach and the leg. He's bleeding heavily.
Oh God, I'm sorry, but the ambulance is, well, you know.
I know, but please, we need something or he's going to die.
Forrest, listen, you're going to have to get him here. We need to see him and we can't get there ourselves right now.
No. We don't have any way to drive him right now. And even if we did, he's bleeding out fast.
All right, listen. We need to buy him time to get here. That means stopping the blood first and then finding someone to stabilize him. To stabilize him, you really need someone with first aid training. Do either of you have any?
No.
No.
Me neither.
damn it.
Yay.
I'm really sorry about this.
We don't.
But I have other patients who can't wait. All I can do is talk you through the procedure as quick as I can and then leave the rest to you. You think you can handle that?
Nope. Because this is nobody has been stabbed.
Hit me.
Okay, from the top. If he's bleeding out, then you need to get him comfortable and try to stem the bleeding. Lay him down. Apply continuous pressure directly to the affected areas. When the bleeding slows, get a clean cloth of some kind and hold it over the wounds.
Get them comfortable. Apply pressure. Clean cloths when slowed. Got it, I think.
You said he was stabbed, right? If the object he was stabbed with is still in him, don't take it out. It's stopping the worst of the bleeding right now. If anything, you should secure it so it stays where it is.
I wouldn't have thought of that. It makes sense, though. God, that was a lot of info. But I think we can handle this.
Glad you got it so far, because there's more to go.
This is a lot to remember. Are you sure you can't stay on the line?
We're wasting time. Please, just let me continue. If he's lost a lot of blood, he may enter shock. If he does, act fast. If you apply a cloth and it's bleeding through, don't remove it. Just apply another on top of it. If it's safe, elevate his legs to get blood circulating to his vital organs. Try to keep him warm. Get him to rest and reassure him. We need the patient to stay calm.
All right, don't replace bandages, elevate his legs, keep him warm and calm.
I'm sorry.
I'm really sorry.
Yeah, me too.
That's as much as I can give you right now. Try to stop the bleeding, find someone to get him stabilized, and get him here as quick as you can.
Thank you.
Good luck.
All right, Forrest. Casey's still on line one.
Thank you.
I'm here. How is Jason doing?
Badly. He's still bleeding. I need help. I've been putting pressure on his stomach wound since you left. But he's still bleeding. I don't know what to do.
That's good, Casey. The nurse said to do that.
What about the knife in his leg? It's gotta be hell. Should I pull it out?
No.
No, don't touch the knife. The bleeding will get worse if you pull it out.
Are you sure? I'm sorry. I'm gonna stop making suggestions.
No, don't worry, Casey. We're a team here. We're all going to get Jason through this. Casey, is his leg wound bleeding right now?
I hate looking at that knife. Yeah. It's bleeding. His stomach is worse, though.
I think we need to secure the knife so it doesn't move around. Do you have anything you can tie around it?
Yeah. There's some laundry piled up on top of the dryer, some cloths on the hood of the car, and what else? I guess I've got my jacket.
Look in the laundry for something like a towel or a shirt. Hold that over the wound.
Okay. Looks like I'm gonna have to buy you some new whites, Jason. Here we go. I'm sorry, Jason. It's secure. I'm putting pressure on his stomach again. I'm starting to think we might make it.
Forrest, can I have a word?
Now isn't the best time, Peggy. Can it wait?
Forrest, it's kind of important.
Okay, well.
All right, give me a second. Casey, I'm going to have a quick word with Peggy. Keep putting that pressure on and let us know when the bleeding is under control. You're doing great.
But what if something happens?
We'll still be here. Just shout if you need anything and we'll be there. I promise. What's up, Peggy?
We can't stay on the line with her all night. Dawn is still out there. Yeah. What if other people need us?
You're right. She's probably on her way to her next target right now.
Exactly. And you heard the nurse. We need someone there with training who can stabilize him. He's got to get to the hospital somehow.
Any suggestions, Peggy?
I might. A little before you started working here, KFAM did a mandatory first aid training course. Me and Karen missed it because we were away on a producer getaway.
You skipped it, didn't you? Never mind. So, how does KFAM's first aid course help us?
Casey said they're at 25 Nancy Drive, right?
Yeah, why?
They put up a bunch of cheap houses around there about 10 years ago. So a bunch of people here at the station live around there.
Do you think any of them could help Casey and Jason?
Probably, but I don't know who lives there. And since I missed the training day, I don't know who knows first aid.
Could you call them and ask?
I don't know everybody's numbers. I've only ever called Karen. Everybody's personnel info is probably in Reggie's office.
Got it. I'll look through their files in Reggie's office. It's a life or death situation. I'm sure they won't mind.
Right. But there are a couple of problems with that. It's sensitive information, so Reggie probably locked it in his safe.
Great. Great. Do you have any idea what the combo for the safe could be?
Not a clue. Reggie's a serial note taker, though. Maybe something in his office will give it away. Right. There is something else.
I'm not gonna like this, am I?
Have you ever heard, the future is floppy?
Peggy, what the hell are you talking about?
I'm talking about floppy disks. Floppy disks are like these futuristic things that have information on them. You put them in a computer and they do something.
Peggy, I know what a floppy disk is.
Anyway, Reggie decided that the future is floppy and started phasing out our physical records and replacing them with these floppy disks. I imagine it's the same for our personnel files.
That's good to know. Since we haven't heard anything from Casey, I'm guessing Jason's okay for now. I'll check out Reggie's office and see what I can find.
You'll need a key for that. I'll just slide it under my door now.
Thanks, Peggy. I just have to look around.
Sliding under the door.
What? Good. I'll patch my mic down to the office so you'll hear me over the intercom.
Yeah, fine. I leave now? Thank you. Where's the office? Is it this one?
I'm not getting in there tonight.
But I want to get in there tonight. Is the office? No, this was already open. Which one is Reggie's? Is it downstairs?
Yes, I remember the pizza man. And it's a good memory.
Please just subscribe. Woo.
Woo. Thank you so much for the 32 months, Bliska. Thank you. Okay, at least we know that someone did something. How are you doing today? Anyway, the future is floppy. Oh, only here for a couple of minutes, so at the work barbecue. Is it any good? Are you enjoying yourself? Alien sightings. You're reading stuff. Surprisingly, it's good. Okay. Oh, that's nice. Only the colleagues are annoying.
Looks like I need a 4-digit code.
Hint. Very important date. Very important date.
You saw nothing.
Eighteen ten eighty-five. Oh. Okay, that's too long. The future is floppy. I just put it in. There we go.
Could this be it?
Nice. Oh my God. Such good sound, those floppy disks, though. Wait, that's nothing to do with. What does it say? Can I just see the puppy? Oh, but this is my personal file. I don't want to read that. I know I didn't. This is Peggy, and she also said she didn't. Oh, but I'm gonna read it anyway, because, you know, it's Peggy.
Hey, Peggy. I think Reggie's on to you and Karen. Maybe don't bring those little drink umbrellas into work for a while.
Mm-hmm. What? Why are you reading my file? You need to find someone who can help Casey. We already know I can't. Don't waste time.
You're right. I'm sorry. I need to focus on possible candidates. I can read the rest of this later.
Only two left. Refuse to engage. Okay. So, John. Where was the intercom here?
Hey, Peggy, you there?
Yeah, I'm here. Did you find what we need?
I think I know who our best bet is to help Casey and Jason.
All right, good work. Who should I...
Hello? Is anybody there? Please pick up!
Casey, I'm here. What's wrong? Sounds like he's going into shock. Casey, just stay calm. It's going to be okay.
But the bleeding seems to slow down.
Put his legs up.
Jason, I'm sorry.
Casey, calm down. You've done everything right.
Put your legs up.
I need you to listen to me, okay? For Jason.
What did the nurse say to do about shock?
Casey, I need you to elevate Jason's legs. We need to get the blood flowing to his vital organs.
Got it. Jason, stay with me. I'm just gonna move you. This might hurt.
Okay. I propped his legs up on some boxes. I'm looking at my notes. We need to get Jason as warm and comfortable as possible. Do you have anything you could use nearby, Casey?
Yeah. I still have some laundry next to me. I'll wrap him in some blankets.
No.
Oh, God!
Don't remove the bandage. Apply another one on top of it. Do you still have something you can use?
I've used the rest of the laundry to keep him warm, so...
You have your
jacket?
Yeah.
I can always get a new one. I'll fix his bandage and get him warm. Hold on, please.
Casey, I need you to be strong for Jason. Sit with him and reassure him that everything's gonna be okay. Okay?
Okay. Please. I can't give him what he needs. Please, help. I can't lose him.
All right, Forrest, we need to hurry. Jason doesn't sound like he's doing too well. You said you knew who to call earlier?
Yeah, John.
Who was it?
John. It's John.
We need to call John Hedges. He lives on Nancy Drive. He didn't really participate in the first aid training, but he's a former war medic. He's probably the most trained person we have.
Really? I never really spoke to him before. A war medic, huh?
Yeah, and according to Reggie's notes, John keeps all of his old equipment at his house. He's something of a hoarder.
All right. What's his number?
542-0735. John, it's Forrest Nash here at KFAM. We have an emergency and we need your help.
Forrest, if this is a work emergency, then it can wait until the goddamn morning. Just leave me a note like everybody else.
But it's not.
John, no, this is a medical emergency. A man has been stabbed by the Whistling Man, or never mind. He's badly hurt, and he's going to die unless we get someone to him now.
The Whistling Man? What kind of joke is this?
John, we're not kidding. A man is gonna die if we don't help him right now.
Seriously, I haven't been called on for over 10 years. Where's the patient? What's his condition?
He's at 25 Nancy Drive. I think we got his friend to stem the bleeding, but he's gone into shock. He's passed out right now.
You say he was stabbed? Do you know the extent of his injuries?
From what we were told, he has two major stab wounds. One to the stomach and one to the leg. The knife is still in his leg, and the stomach wound is open.
Understood. Let me grab a few supplies and I'll head right over. Damned if he dies on my watch.
Thank you, John. We'll let him know you're on your way.
Good luck.
Hello, Casey. Are you there? How are we doing?
Bad. Jason seemed really weak, and then just started thrashing.
When he was thrashing around, did he hurt you in any way, or are you okay?
I'm fine, but Jason passed out. Please tell me you found someone to help.
We did.
Casey, help is on the way. My colleague will be there soon. And with that, the show moves on. We're sending our best wishes to Jason.
Yeah, I'm going back upstairs.
Well, after all that excitement, I think we could use some music.
Come back upstairs when you're ready.
I was born ready. Oh.
I know him. You love him. This is Roddy Snatcher with his new single, Final Breath.
It's getting pretty late. This might be your last break for the night, so try to enjoy it. Give me a buzz when you want to go back on air.
Do I want... I wonder why sometimes we can't shoot. Okay, let's
roll.
You got it. We've got another call coming through too.
Welcome back to 189.16, The Scream. I believe we have another caller on the line. How are you tonight, caller?
Forrest, it's me, Roller Ricky. Oh, and Maxie's here too.
Good to hear from you again. How are you both doing?
Oh, we're good, man, thanks to you. You're like our guardian angel.
Mm-hmm. That wouldn't be a bad look for you, Forrest. A little white wing halo number. Maybe something for the KFAM Halloween party.
All right, everyone, let's calm down. Ricky, I'm just glad we could help you and Maxie.
Is there anything else we can help you with, Ricky?
Actually, I think I have some info that might help you.
Oh? What's that?
See, man, me and Jason know each other.
You know each other?
Yeah, we went to Gallus High and played on the football team together. He was a gnarly offensive linesman, and I was our star wide receiver. Runner Ricky, they called me.
All right, and what does that have to do with tonight?
Well, because George, the guy who drowned, he was on our team too.
Keep talking. What happened?
We had our first team party on the night he drowned. He seemed like such a good dude.
Ricky, were you there when George drowned?
No, man. Once the party turned, I beat feet out of there. Man, I remember George and his girl there. There was a whole lot of love.
I've not been bored yet in this game. Like, you don't do a lot because you're just listening to the stories, but I have not been bored.
Ricky, listen, this is very important. I need to know everything about her.
I didn't really know her before or see her after that. I never even got her name, man. I just remember he called her Beam.
Then what did she look like? Please, tell us anything you remember.
I just remember a pretty girl, man. I'm sorry.
Ricky, you said the party didn't last long. What happened?
We were just having a good time. And then the next thing I knew, everyone was running for their life. I looked up and saw a goddamn whistling man in the trees. And I never ran so fast in my life. I ran straight home.
I'm guessing it was Whistling Night, wasn't it? That the Whistling Man was just another kid.
Yeah. I don't know how George died, but I always felt like if anyone deserved to die that night, it should have been me. And
Ricky, it wasn't your fault. You're not a bad person.
I know that now, man. It took a long time to learn, but yeah, just thought I'd tell you all what I know.
Thank you, Ricky.
This helps. Thank you.
You got it, man. Anyway, I think it's time for me and Maxie to free up your phone lines. Thanks for listening, man. I'll let you to it.
Night, Ricky. All right, folks. Looks like we got a new lead in the case. If anyone has any info about this mysterious being, please call in.
If she was George's girlfriend back then, she's probably in her mid to late 30s now. Huh. Oh, we have another call coming in, but hang on.
What's up, Peggy? Peggy?
You're gonna want to take this call off the air.
Who is it?
Just do it.
All right, folks, it's time for another track. Here's one to help you sit back and relax. We'll be right back after this. I hope this is good news, Peggy. Who have we got?
Find out for yourself on line one.
Hello?
Forrest, I'm glad I got back through to you. Sounds like it's been a busy night, huh?
Surprise! It's Leslie, our 911 operator, leading the charge from Henderson to come save us. It's so good to hear from you. Are you okay?
I am. I'm driving back with an officer from Henderson now. We got back into radio range a little while ago. We've been listening in, but haven't been able to get through until now.
It's been nonstop since you left. Please tell us you're bringing help.
You bet! I'm leading a whole goddamn squad towards Gallows Creek as we speak. Turns out somebody had cut the phone lines. They had no idea what was happening.
That's great news! That's crazy about the phone lines, though. Do you think the Whistling Man cut them?
I'm guessing so. I don't know how he... how she... how the Whistling Man did it. But that doesn't matter right now. Listen, we're coming in hot, but we need your help. I know Gallows Creek isn't a big town, but if we don't know where the Whistling man is, we can't get him. Her. That's where you come in.
Okay, what do you need?
You can count on us. What do you need?
It might be a long shot, but here goes. The whistling man already called up a few times. I bet she calls again. We're still a little ways out of town, so if she calls, stall her. Buy as much time as you can for us to get in. And while you're talking to her, try to figure out where she is. We'll be listening in, so once her location is known, we'll head straight there and end this nightmare.
I'll do my best.
I know you will. Heck, I can see the headlines now. Forrest Nash's interview of a lifetime. Anyway, I'll radio the other cars and tell them the plan is a go. Hopefully the next time I see you, it'll be with our killer behind bars. Take care now.
We'll see you soon, Leslie. Oh, thank God. It sounds like this is almost over. We're nearly through this.
Best we don't waste any time, then. Let's get back on air.
You got it. Bringing you back live now.
Welcome back to The Scream with me, Forrest Nash. The line is lit up, but before I get to our next caller, I just want to say, things are looking up. It's almost over. But for now, let's bring in our next caller. Evening, caller. This is Forrest Nash.
Hello, Forrest. This is John Hedges.
John.
I'm here with Casey. I wanted to give you an update on Jason.
John! Is he going to be okay?
He's a fighter. He'll be fine. We've got him stabilized and resting in a bed. We're preparing to move him to the hospital.
Thank you so much! If you hadn't been there, then... God, I don't even want to think about what would have happened.
Of course, Casey. We're just happy he's okay.
John, Casey,
oh, this is creepy.
All the work.
Like, do you see my arm?
Tell Jason soon from us, whenever he's up for it.
Well, why don't you tell him yourself?
Is this
my
Forrest?
My arm isn't there anymore. I'm missing part. Yeah, I guess they are on their way to me.
Jason, we meet at last.
It's good to hear you, Jason. How are you?
Oh, well, you know, I've got a hole in my stomach, and there's a knife in my leg, but John gave me something to take the edge off. So, I might feel even better than either of you.
Take it easy until you get to St. Gabriel's.
I will. But, before that, I needed to call you. I'm guessing the whistling man is still out there?
Yes, the whistling man's still out there. Why do you ask? You know something about the whistling man, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
Can we talk about what happened earlier?
Go for it.
We spoke to Roller Ricky not long after you were attacked.
You spoke to Ricky? Is he all right?
He is now. I mean, he was attacked earlier, but this call came after.
Hey, guys, I'm really sorry, but there's a call on the other line. I just need to make sure we don't have another situation brewing. You fill Jason in on what happened. I'll be right back.
Sure, Peggy. Sorry, Jason. Where was I? Ah, yep. Ricky's fine. You don't need to worry about him.
That's a relief.
He told us about George.
Sounds like everything's finally coming out now. It's been tough to hold it all in.
Sounds like you've been holding back about something awful, Jason.
I'm part of the reason my best friend is dead, Forrest. And the few who knew about it said if I ever said anything, I'd find myself in jail. For a long time, it was hell. And then the town just moved on. Like he'd never existed.
What happened that night?
I went along with the stupid prank, that's what. Whistling night. Some of the guys on the football team had an idea for a way we could haze the newcomers. We decided to plan a party in the woods and have the whistling man crash it. It was
was stupid. We each had a role. I was the stabbed friend. At the party that night, I left the group for a second. Met our whistling man. Pretended to get stabbed in front of everyone. Started an almighty panic. Those screams. That was the last time I saw or heard George alive.
How did George die, Jason?
I don't know. I was playing dead. But when I heard her scream...
Ricky mentioned a girl named Bean. Is that who you mean?
Bean. Oh, yeah. I guess George did call her that. Yeah. He called her Bean. I heard her again tonight, Forrest. Her name was...
What? What happened? Are we still on air?
No, we're not. Seems like the power is completely gone.
How do we get it back on?
I don't, we can use the emergency generator.
It's Mary Campbell.
Reggie picked it up a while ago.
She was a drama.
An emergency broadcast?
I think it's Mary Campbell. Belle Bean.
Fair point!
What?
It's in the storage area, in the far back corner, up on the wall. You might have spotted it earlier when you were digging around for all those tapes. It'll have a big red button. Just press that. I'll see you when you're back.
Wait, what am I looking for? I wasn't listening. I was looking at Mary. No, this next probably shorty. Like in the storage area down.
Far back corner. Why is this station so big?
No, why is this a freaking maze?
That must be it.
Boom! We've got power!
The whistling man.
I need to warn Peggy.
Can I? There was no... It sounded like they were walking away, right?
Peggy, are you there? Are you... Peggy!
I need to get back upstairs.
I am protecting myself with the screwdriver. What was that for sound? Why is the game suddenly breaking up?
Oh no. Peggy, where'd you go? No way. This can't be happening. A call. Where's Peggy, Don?
Have some patience, Forrest. It's almost the end of the night. Almost the end of the show. But it's not over just yet. We've got a little time still. So let's make the most of it.
All right, let's.
I'm happy to hear that.
Huh?
I thought we'd end tonight's Whistling Man special with a special guest. The one who started it all. Let me take that out of your
Nate.
Mouth. And...
You crazy bitch! Let me go!
Welcome to the air, Mr. Teddy Gallows Jr.
Wait.
It's all gonna come out tonight, Teddy. Your daddy and his money saved you 20 years ago. But he made you crawl out of his coffin with all the money in the world.
Wait, where the hell is Teddy? How are you talking to him if you're here with me?
Because I'm not there with you, Forrest. I'm here with Teddy. And if he says where that is, well, he knows he'll get it.
That's Don, then?
Wait, then who am I looking at?
No,
Forrest Nash, let me introduce you
Peggy.
And all of Gallows Creek to my boy, Henry Barrow.
Hi, Henry. Nice to meet you.
Don't mind him. He's just shy.
So there were two whistling men tonight.
That
explains how you're always able to get around town so quickly. And that's how you escaped the secret archives in the newspaper office.
Don't think I've forgotten about that, Forrest. Locking my sweet boy away like an animal.
Hang on. Did you say Barrow? Then, are you...
Let me just get this mask off. Damn uncomfortable thing. No wonder Mooney went crazy wearing this. There we go.
Marie?
That's what
Campbell?
I said, right?
George's old girl. Oh, well, it sure has been years since I last saw. Oh, God damn it.
I'd be quiet if I were you, Teddy.
But
I'd listen to Forrest. Everyone's gonna know now what Teddy did. He killed George that night. This night. 20 years ago.
Listen to me. You...
You're gonna talk when I talk to you. And not a moment before. Meanwhile, Forrest, I'm gonna give you the chance to talk. You're gonna help me reveal what really happened to George all those years ago.
Okay, Marie. I'll do it.
Good. Then let's talk about the night George was murdered.
Murdered? Listen, I...
Everybody hates Teddy. I mean...
I said you speak when you're spoken to. Now, I know you've done some good work tonight in piecing together what happened to George 20 years ago. And that's why I want you to interview us.
If you say so, I'm not really in a position to argue.
I'm happy we have your cooperation. Do a good job. And hell, you might be the only one to leave here alive.
But Peggy, where's Peggy? Where is Peggy?
I need to drag this out. If I can buy Leslie time to get back to Gallows Creek, and if I can find out where Marie is, then this can end. Teddy, we'll start with you. Just, talk me through what happened that night. How did it start?
How would I know? It was 20 years ago.
Do you want to die, Teddy? Because if you don't, start talking.
What the hell? God damn it. Okay. Our first team party was coming up. And when I saw the
back
date, I had an idea for a way we could prank the new guys.
Okay.
It was the night Mooney, the original Whistling Man, vanished.
Peggy.
Isn't that right?
Yes.
That's okay. Right. That, hell, it seemed too perfect to pass up. I was just surprised no one had ever thought to do it before.
Wait. You mean this was the first Whistling Night?
I
Keep talking, Teddy.
We went up near Whistling Point. God, who was there? Me, Jason, and George, of course. But George didn't come alone. He brought Marie.
And Roller Ricky, he was there too, wasn't he?
Yes, Ricky was there too. Runner Ricky, our wide receiver. I helped him off the bottle, you know.
Nobody cares.
I'm a decent man.
Mm-hmm. Is that so?
Yes, it is. He came apart one day. Some people do. He had some issues. Wasn't stable. I didn't want him to hurt his chances in life. So I helped him keep himself together.
You were afraid he would talk about that night, weren't you?
Keep talking.
About midway through the night? Put the prank into action.
We looked up at the trees and saw Jason there, bloody, like he'd just been stabbed.
Screaming. Hello.
George and I.
You beautiful
Ricky,
human being. How are you doing?
We got left behind. But Ricky was in on it too. I know he was. He and Teddy were as close as anybody. Teddy must have told him the plan.
No, Marie, you're wrong. Ricky didn't know.
What?
Did you miss that part of the broadcast? I spoke to him earlier. He had no idea what was happening. He said he was as terrified as anybody. Isn't that right, Teddy? You didn't tell him, did you?
Ricky never could keep his mouth shut. If we told him, he would have given everything away.
But he... well... it doesn't matter. He didn't run his mouth enough to tell anybody about it afterwards. He's still guilty.
It was just a stupid prank.
Getting ready to go up to the town. On the town. Nice. Hydrate. Yes, sir. And that's good to see you're good. It's a prank.
How can you still say it was just a prank?
Oh, come on! God damn it!
You made George think Jason had been murdered. He thought his best friend was dead.
And so tonight you stabbed him for real?
It's the role he wanted to play.
Jason's still alive, Marie. He was with a friend. We talked her through how to stop the bleeding and got him professional help just in time.
I want to know why the kid in the maze had to die, though.
Shame he didn't have the good sense to die earlier. He's gonna regret that. Enough about him. Me and George took off running, but somehow we got separated in the woods. I ended up near the bottom of Whistling Point, and when I noticed George wasn't with me, I panicked. And then, I don't know how he snuck up on me, but the Whistling Man grabs me. I scream, and he starts laughing, telling me it's just a joke.
I can stall for time. time here. How did you feel in that moment?
I felt like nothing was real. I felt small and confused. And
who was under the mask, Marie? Who was the whistling man?
It was Chuck. Chuck Brody. Laughing away. But then he stops. And he's looking up. At the top of Whistling Point.
What was he looking at? Teddy. What happened next?
Nothing.
What was happening?
It was just...
Teddy!
George... fell off Whistling Point.
Why'd he fall, Teddy?
He just...
You pushed him. You were up there. You were dressed as the Whistling Man, too, and...
I didn't push him, goddammit! I just chased him up there, and... he kept backing up. When I saw he was about to go over, I reached out. That's what you saw.
You liar.
It's not my fault. He didn't know it was a joke. If he'd had any brains, he would have realized.
Ugh. Yeah, he deserves to get beat.
No one's
Everybody hates Teddy.
After all you did.
Even if you didn't push him, you still chased him to his death.
I can't be blamed for someone not getting a joke.
I think Marie would disagree. But if you really felt that way, why the cover-up?
Yeah.
My future was at stake, Nash. You know what it's like. People like us are bred for bigger things. I'm going to be the mayor of this town, Forrest. And then governor. And then, who knows? What happened that night was tragic. It should never have happened. But it was a mistake. It was just a stupid joke gone wrong. So my father sent Clive out to clean it up. Why should a blip ruin my...
He wasn't a blip, Marie.
His father covered it up from there. I searched for George's body all night, but...
You never found his body, Marie?
I looked all night. Jogger found him the next morning, washed up on the river. Instead of telling the truth, she lied. She said she found him in the reservoir.
Our jazz runner, Sandra Sharp.
Everyone was in on it, Forrest. Even the coroner wrote a fake report. Said George was drinking. That he just got himself into trouble. And...
Fake report? I only heard the tapes.
You'd be disgusted by it.
For all it's worth, Virginia didn't have much of a choice. She had a sick sister whose treatments she couldn't afford. She played along with the gallows to save her sister's life. And her own.
Even still, she should have told the truth. I did my part. I tried everything I could think of. I even went to the newspaper, but no, that coward killed the story. We'll take care of Maurice Russell later.
You've been through hell, Marie. I'm sorry.
You've got no idea.
Wait a sec.
You're at the football field.
Jesus Christ! Forrest, you idiot!
Jim at Gallows Creek High.
I told you not to do that.
Wait.
Aw. I didn't read this. I didn't read the thing.
Dead too now, isn't he?
He is. Anyway, I think that about wraps up the interview with Teddy. So.
Marie? Where? Oh my god.
Peggy!
Teddy!
Peggy. It's been so long since I've seen your face. I worried you wouldn't come. Got me.
I'd never forget my own sister.
Will someone please explain to me what's happening?
Wanna explain, Peggy?
Earlier, while you were speaking to Jason, I got a call. Do you remember?
Mm-hmm.
Well, it was from Dawn. She said that my sister Marie was there that night George died. That I should come to the gym for a reunion.
And when you walked in, you found out
that my sister is the Whistling Man.
Good to see you too, Peggy.
Why didn't you tell me any of this?
She said that it was my last chance to see my sister. I knew if I told you, you'd try to stop me or come with me when we need you on the radio. And I just...
You should have said something. You should have told me.
I know, okay? I should have. But I didn't imagine this situation then, so just... What happened to you, Marie? You just disappeared one day.
I pulled the things I need to do like this. Like the fast ones, I
to do something about what happened that night. But did they care? No, they don't stay quiet. They only care.
I'm so
glad. It's not your fault. Really, it's Mom and Dad I should be seeing right now. But since they're dead and gone, well, I'll have to settle for the next best thing.
Wait.
Yeah, Eugene was the boy.
Is that why you went after that kid in the maze? Yeah, Eugene Stein? Because his parents?
That's right. Eugene's parents were there that night too. But they got themselves killed in a bus accident. And since only their child was left.
Marie, please.
Mom and Dad are gone, Peggy. Besides, you forgot me. Just like the rest. You forgot.
Is there any way I could prove Peggy didn't forget Marie?
Mm-hmm. Wait, can I just throw this? Okay, I placed it.
It hurt to be forgotten. I never forgot you! Well, no one's gonna forget now.
Peggy! No!
Wait, no, but I'm fucked. Well, I'll die then. It's fine. I don't know how I could how to do this. Should I just walk out with this.
Henry.
You don't
have
to
do this. There's still time to make the right decision.
Okay, this made me.
Henderson police! Freeze! No! Henry! Get out of there!
So loud. Why was it so loud?
Henderson police! Freeze!
Forrest.
Leslie? How's Peggy?
She. Oh my god.
Peggy, where's Marie?
Gone. Bolted right as we got here. The police are right on her heels. Won't be long now. It's over, Forrest.
It's over. Well, if I would have gotten to the cart earlier.
Come in. One suspect is in custody. Trail the other suspect into the nearby woods.
I think I'm going to play this another time. And then maybe I can keep people alive. But I don't think so, because I think the kid, like Eugene, had to die. That's way too loud, the music though. Oh wait, did I skip the epilogue as well? Wait, let me continue. Hopefully I will go back to the...
I never forgot you!
Well, no one's gonna forget now.
But here, I still have the card! For next time, I need to remember to get the card quickly. Okay, now I know this is going to be loud. So I'll just... take the headphones off. It is a cool game. Yes, I like it very much. But I don't... if there's still an epilogue...
You don't have to do this. There's still... time to make the right
then
decision.
Then I want to see that as well. Because I wonder.
Henderson police, freeze!
I wonder if there's
Forrest.
Leslie?
They will make
oh my god.
More of this? Because I really like it.
God.
It's such a good game. I haven't been bored or really felt like I was stuck at all. Yeah, this. There's a moth. Where did it go? Oh, there it is, man.
Officer Trout, come in. One suspect is in custody.
the mold, though. Frequency. But I want to know if there's more, or just the song. No. No, it was at the... It loaded in the point where I could not save her anymore. So that's a shame. So maybe in the next playthrough I have to manually save every time I think something important might happen, if I remember. So if I fuck up, I can just reload. Uh-oh. She's gonna jump as well. Oh. Oh, I thought we got him. Put your hands in the air! Get down on the ground!
Don't move! Nobody else has to get hurt!
Yeah. That was to be expected.
Officer Luca, do you have a visual?
Negative. No sign of the suspect anywhere.
Did they fly off? I think tomorrow I will eat pizza. Pizza. Not by Bonties, because Bonties was annoying as hell, but... Okay, that was it. Oh, that was it. It was just the radio things. I really, really, really like this game. It might be boring because you have to listen a lot and just, you know, if you don't. If you need action, then this could be boring, but it's really good. I haven't felt like I was waiting too long for anything at all. And I think I will come back to it and try to save as many people as I can. But for now, it's here. It is 22:22, which is a very good time to stop the stream. The dogs need to go out and, you know, what am I doing? No, I might do something else. I pressed the wrong button. So thank you all so much for being here. How? Oh. Yeah, if you like the game, pick it up. If you haven't seen everything of it, because I don't know how much it will terminate if you do things the right way instead of the wrong way. But, yeah, thank you all so much, and I hope to see you next time. Bye-bye.